Hello, everyone. Thanks for coming to the presentation or the workshop today. We're going to go ahead and get started. It's just about 3:03. My name is Lindsay Pilliod, and I'm one of the reference specialists at the Alpharetta Campus Library. And today we're going to be talking about poster presentations for beginners. So, first question, what is a poster presentation? Poster presentations are a great way to exhibit and share a visual summary of your research project at a conference, professional meeting, or at school. Most poster sessions are events that are attended by both you and your audience, meaning that you will be standing near your poster, talking to people, and answering questions about your research. Other poster sessions may be unattended, meaning that people will be looking at your poster without any additional context or explanation from you. Oftentimes, there'll be an attended session after which the posters are left hanging unattended. Posters can be printed out on large pieces of paper, displayed electronically on large screens, or virtually via a smaller screen like a computer, tablet, or phone. There are many different software programs that you can use to create poster presentations. These are the top three that most people use. They're all free and super easy to use. Google Slides and Canva are both web-based applications that you can access anywhere you have an internet browser. And Microsoft PowerPoint is actually free for you to use as long as you're enrolled or employed at GSU. If you don't have it on your computer, you can go to the gsu.edu website and click on Students and then Technology. If you scroll down on the right side, you'll see an option to download academic software. And if you click on the yellow, which is See Available Software, if you scroll down, you'll see that you're able to download Microsoft Office Suite with just your GSU username and password, and you can put that on your personal computer. So, planning your poster. When you are planning your poster, always make sure that you're following the instructions given to you by your professor or the conference that you're presenting at. What I'm sharing with you today are just some general guidelines and suggestions. There's no hard and fast rules as far as posters go. Everyone seems to have their own requirements. So really make sure that you follow the instructions given to you by your class or the conference or meeting you're going to. The total text displayed on your poster should be less than 1,000 words. Your poster shouldn't be a large printout of a research paper or include big blocks of text. You'll really want to edit and narrow down your information as much as possible and try to really focus on the central points that you're trying to make. When deciding what information to include on your poster, your first question should be, who is my audience? If you're presenting at an academic or a scientific conference where your audience is familiar with your subject area, you can use technical terms. However, if your audience is fellow students or members of the public who may or may not be familiar with your subject area, make sure that you use terms that everyone is going to understand. On this poster, there are some typical headings that you can use to organize your information. You do not ever need to use all of these. These are just suggestions and sort of an example of how they would look on the poster. Make sure that you're only using the headings that make sense for your presentation. Your title is what draws people into your poster. You want it to be clear and catchy and not overly wordy. And then your author name would go right below the title, and that will be the same every poster once you want to have that those two things on there. And the rest are really optional, depending on the subject that you're presenting. There's an introduction section, materials and methods, analysis, results, conclusions, and some of the more important aspects of your poster is you want to make sure that you're citing all the unoriginal elements of your presentation using the same citation style. That's really important because you don't want to use other people's work and not have them properly cited on your poster. Acknowledgements. It's always nice to acknowledge those who have helped you with your presentation. It might be your fellow classmates, your colleagues, staff, professors, and make sure to mention any funding or other support that you received. One of the more important elements of your poster is going to be your contact information. Be sure that your contact information is on there so people can follow up with you after the presentation. Definitely include your name, your email address, and consider using a QR code for easy follow-up, which you see in the bottom corner. If you've never used a QR or never used or generated a QR code before, it's super easy. You go on any internet browser and Google or search for QR code generator. I chose the website qr.io, and you can see on this slide that there are a ton of different options for what information you want your QR code to have. You can embed a link, you can embed your email, or even a PDF handout of the information that your poster covered. For today, I just generated a QR code that will send me an email to link, to ask for more information. It's really easy. So layout and sizing. This is also a really important element. You want to make sure that you're following the guidelines set by either your professor or the conference, because for most poster presentations, the most common orientation layout is going to be landscape. 48 inches by 36 inches is probably the most popular size for printed posters. You don't want to set your poster orientation to portrait unless it is required and specified in your instructions. Another important element of poster design is your margins. You do not want to place text, graphics, titles, logos, or any other design elements near the edges of your poster. Your background color, it will be okay to fill to the edges. If you don't leave at least 1 to 2 inches around the sides of your poster, information that you include there may get cut off by either the printer or the screen that you're displaying it on. This probably goes without saying, but it's always good to have a reminder. If you are creating a professional looking poster, you don't want to use fun fonts or any sort of crazy hard to read types of text. You're going to want to stick to the basic kind of boring, really easy to read fonts. So you save the creative stuff for maybe the graphics that you want to use in your poster, but definitely make sure that you want to make sure that everything is really easy to read. Using different size text in your presentation is going to help you make your most important points stand out. So there should be noticeable size differences between the different elements of your poster. Here you can see these are suggested for a 48 inch by 36 inch presentation. Of course, the sizes have changed depending on the size of the poster that you're creating, but these are just a general guideline. You really need to stand back and look at it to make sure that what your text sizes make sense for the size poster that you're making. So your title should be in bold text between 80 and 100 points. Author's name should be at least 50 to 80. Section headings, 40 to 60 points. And body text should be 24 to 50 point. A lot of people will be standing back, maybe even 5 feet away from your poster. So you want to make sure that everyone can read the information that's there. Make sure that your text boxes are also a consistent width throughout the poster. Your body text should be just plain type. Don't underline or italicize your body text. It makes it really difficult for people to read, especially from a distance. So using graphs, photographs, charts, illustrations, maps, drawings, data visualizations are all great ways to break up the text in your poster and add interest. If you're using images, lower quality images like JPEGs, GIFs, or screenshots, you just can't use them when you're creating a large poster, either printed or for a large screen. The images are going to appear blurry, and they're going to be pixelated like the image on the right of your screen. Images used for websites are really low resolution. People want websites to load quickly, so they use the lowest possible resolution that they can. So those are not the types of images that you want to be using on a large poster. You want to be using 300 DPI JPEG or TIFF files. And if they appear blurry, if your images or whatever sort of graphics you're using appear blurry at all, don't use them. Find something else. So here is an example of a bad poster. There are way too many different colors to the point where your eyes have a hard time figuring out where to focus. What am I looking at? You know, your eyes just are going to all these brightly colored design elements. The font is really small, so if I was standing back from this, I wouldn't be able to read it. And there doesn't seem to be any real organization to the information. Overall, this poster is really distracting and difficult to read. And it's also printed on a glossy paper. So the overhead lights or lights from a window reflect off and make it impossible to see the entire poster. This is an example by one of our Alpharetta librarians of a good poster. The text is concise and to the point. There's really good organization of information. The sections all have even margins. The data and graphs used are simple and easy to read. And there are differences in the text sizes between the title, authors, heading, and body text. This is another example of a well-designed poster. You can see that the information presented is concise. There are not a lot of distracting colors. The text is evenly presented and large enough to be read from a distance. And there are differences in size between the different sections of text. So something else about preparing a poster presentation is that you're going to have to talk about it. At attended poster session events, whether it's at a conference, in your classroom, or even at the library, you'll most likely be standing near your poster hoping to interact with people. You want to be prepared to discuss your topic and answer any questions that people might have. So it's really important to prepare a short 1 to 2 minute talk about your work so you have something planned out to say, so you're not just standing there and sort of humming and, you know, not really having anything to say. You can start by introducing yourself, talk about your background. You could say something like, I'm a first year student at Georgia State University, and I made this poster for my English class. And then talk a little bit more about what you're discussing. Finally, printing your poster. GSU has a full service print shop that can print just about anything you need. You can submit your poster file online anytime. And there's also the option to visit one of their two locations. One is on the Atlanta campus and the other is at the Clarkston campus. And you can always give them a call if you have specific questions about printing. The Paw Prints website says it takes about 3 to 4 days to print a large poster, but ideally you should probably leave at least a week to allow for any misprints or mistakes or other unforeseen issues. That's it for this part of the presentation. There's a QR code here that will lead you to the LibGuide that I created for poster presentations, and there's a ton more information there. And I'm going to just go over the LibGuide a little bit with you guys. This is the LibGuide that I made for poster presentations. It's got a ton more information. In this guide, you'll find just a brief introduction and overview. And then I have links to, these are the links to all the software that you can use to design your poster. This will bring you to the GSU website, and you can download the Microsoft Office Suite there. Has information about planning your poster with all of, and you know, details about all the headings that we that I spoke about earlier. A little more about layout and sizing and the poster sizing, fonts to use, graphics. And this is pretty important. There's a really good libguide on copyright. So if you're going to be using any unoriginal elements in your poster design, you'll definitely want to read up on how to properly attribute the different things that you'll be using. There are a couple examples of well-made posters, and we also were lucky enough to have our director of communications design a template for us that anyone can download and use. This will work in both PowerPoint and Google Slides and probably any other design program. You can download this to your computer and change up any of the elements and make it your own. So it's really great to have that, so you're not just starting from scratch. But if you do want to start from scratch and design your own presentation, I included some just instructions on how to create custom slide in PowerPoint and in Google Slides, because it's a little different than just going in and creating a PowerPoint presentation. You have to change the size of the slides. Let's see. There is more information about talking about your poster, and I really didn't want to reinvent the wheel. There are some really good overviews down here in these text boxes about creating poster talks. Go into much more detail than I could in the short amount of space that I have here. I think the poster checklist is really one of the more important parts of your poster design. Before you want to submit your file or for printing or exhibit, you really want to make sure that everything is correct and that it looks good and nothing's pixelated or blurry. And so this would be a really good checklist to go through. And also something that a lot of people overlook about poster presentation or poster sessions is determining how your poster is going to hang. Do you need tape? Do you need push pins? Will you need binder clips? Every conference is different. Every class is different. There might, you know, at the one of the images earlier in the PowerPoint presentation, posters were hung up in the Dunwoody campus library. So how do you hang up a poster at the library and when it, you know, on Windows? So these are all sort of considerations that you should really take into account when you're thinking about how you're going to exhibit your poster. And then here's just a reiteration of paw prints and their contact information. Definitely give them a call or stop by. They're really happy to talk about poster printing, and they'll be happy to help you with any questions that you have. And then lastly, there are some really good links to other resources from other universities that I used to sort of learn about this subject, and links to everything basically that I talked about in the rest of the presentation. So that's about it for me. Does anybody have any questions?